Welcome friends. In this video, I am going to talk about planet Ketu and how to interpret the results of this planet in our horoscopes. So first of all, what is Ketu? Ketu is the south node of planet Moon. So Moon happens to revolve around Sun, and when it comes to the position at the south, at that node or at that junction, that point is called as Ketu. And Ketu is basically a body that is having no mass. It is just a shadowy body that is called as Ketu. And the north point where the Moon is placed while rotating around planet Sun, that point is called as Rahu. And both these are shadowy planets. They don't have any mass and they are totally opposite in their results and in their characteristics. So wherever your Ketu is present or wherever your Rahu is present, these are the two houses where you would undergo things related to your past lives, that is related to your karmic debts. So if you are karmically due for something, that house will contain your Rahu. And if you karmically owe something towards others in the form of duties or in the form of any other thing, that house will have your Ketu. So Ketu is basically something which you could not perform well in your past lives, and that obligation, that duties you are carrying forward in this life. And that is the reason why whichever house your Ketu is present, that house energy, you would have to undergo some sufferings, or you will feel the duties towards that house, which means there would be some sufferings related to that house, and you would be in want of the happiness coming through that house. So if Ketu is present with any planet, which means it is conjunct with any other planet, the karak tattvas of that planet would also give you sufferings. So you will never be able to enjoy the good results of that karak tattva completely, because you owe something towards that karak tattva. You had done something wrong towards that karak tattva in your past life, and that is why your Ketu is conjunct with that. So now the thing is that because Ketu is a highly karmic planet, so its tendencies is to absorb the results of any given house or planet, and it will make sure that the complete happiness or the complete results of that house or planets are not being felt. So its results are to be studied like this. Now the other point is that Ketu is, as per mythology, it is the lower part of the body of a dragon, and the upper part of the body of the dragon is called as Rahu. Now the story which is associated with this is that in the ancient times, as per mythology, when the gods and the demons, they wanted to churn the ocean. So they wanted to churn it because they were expecting some nectar to come out of it. And both the sides wanted to drink that nectar. And somehow the demons, they caught hold of that nectar. And they are depicted in the form of this dragon. And Sun and Moon, they saw this dragon drinking that nectar. So they told Lord Vishnu to catch hold of him. So Lord Vishnu quickly went there and he wanted to get back that nectar. But by that time, the dragon had already drank that nectar. And Lord Vishnu cut off the head area of that dragon. But the thing is, by that time the dragon had already finished the nectar, so it became immortal. So the head part became the Rahu and the lower part became the Ketu. So that is how the story of Rahu Ketu goes. But we know that astrologically it is the node of planet Moon. So now the traits of Ketu. Ketu is basically going to give you very positive traits when it is strong in your chart and unafflicted. But if it is weak in your chart and if it is afflicted, in those cases it will give you very negative results. So what are the positive results of Ketu? Let's talk about that. So Ketu's positive results are like, it will make you very intellectual, very research oriented, very deep in your thoughts, very studious, and you would be a lover of solitude. You would be happy, contented by your own presence, by your own self. And Ketu also creates interests towards occult sciences, towards spirituality, towards meditation, towards the higher side of life. Why? Because Ketu has got no head. So its head is, I would say, unlimited. It's infinite. It is connected to the higher side of life. Its base is very little. So its material needs are fulfilled very easily, very quickly. What are the material needs? These are like human being related, or related to money matters, or related to the things that gives us comforts. So Ketu's body is limited. So it is happy and contented with only limited amount of material things. But when it comes to the higher side, when it comes to the spiritual side, Ketu wants as much as it can, because there is no head, there is no limit. So that is why a good Ketu makes you very intelligent. So a lot of people have got very contrary views about Ketu, that it is a headless body. It should be treated like the way as I told you, that its intellectual needs are infinite and it gives you interest towards higher sides of life, and it makes you interested in occult science or research. Lots of doctors are seen through this good Ketu in their charts. And Ketu is also a karka of salvation, which means, see, after death, the soul rests in the house which is related to the 12th house. So that is the place where the soul will rest until it gets another body, that is your 5th house. Your 5th house is your next birth. Your 9th house is your previous life. And your lagna is your current life. So the soul will rest in the 12th house. Because Ketu is all about detachment, it's all about a want of something, or you can say not wanting something. That is the right word, I would say. So when Ketu is present in the 12th house, which is already a house of moksha, a house of salvation, Ketu itself is the significator of salvation. So here it will make sure that it doesn't need any further lives. So that means it's an indication that the person will attain salvation after this life. But I will make a separate video on the placement of Ketu in different houses, so as to understand how it will behave in various houses. So here I will only talk about where it is considered as good. So before I talk about the placement where it is considered good, let me also talk about what does a bad Ketu do if it is afflicted, or if it is in your 6, 8, 12 houses. Yeah, in 12th house, it will definitely give you some troubles also, along with salvation. So what does a bad Ketu do, or a weak Ketu do? So these people would have less interest in studies. Their focuses would not be up to the mark. They would find hard to focus on anything that is related to learning. They may or may not be spiritual, and they do get cheated also, because when a person believes the other side very easily, they are not using their own sense of logic, then they tend to get cheated. So if your Ketu is weak, there is a fear of getting cheated, and there is also a fear of amputation of some sorts. Because see, if Ketu is present in 6, 8, 12, and it is, if it is afflicted by a malefic planet like Saturn or Mars, in that case, this Ketu can cause amputation of that organ or of that body part where it is present. So Ketu's placement should be studied very carefully, because after Saturn, this is the second most malefic planet, and the third most malefic planet after Ketu is Rahu, and then comes the planet Mars and then Sun. So Ketu will take away everything if it is in bad affliction and if it is in a negative house, I mean in your Trig Bhavas. So its placement has to be studied very carefully. Now comes the good sides of Ketu. What are the houses which are considered good for planet Ketu? See, the trinal houses, that is 1, 5, 9, these are the houses of your spirituality. These are the houses of your dharmas, so dharma trikons. So here, because Ketu is all about moksha, so if it is present in the dharma trikon houses, then it will promote moksha, because in the first house it will make sure your needs are limited and you are more towards the spiritual sides of life. Anyways, it will make you want of many things in life in the first house, so it makes you inclined towards spirituality. In the fifth house, which is the house of religious deeds, and it's also the house of your intellect. So here the intellect would be towards the higher learnings of life, and the person would do deeds as a matter of his duty when it is placed in the fifth house. Now in the ninth house, that is the house of your higher learning, or it's the house of your religion. So these people would also be inclined to know more about the foreign religion, and they would be very spiritually inclined. They would do deeds which will be out of, they would do things out of no selfish motive. So this is how this Ketu in the ninth house should be read. And these are the three houses where it is definitely considered good. The other three houses are your 4th house, 8th house and the 12th house. Here Ketu will help you attain salvation very easily. Of course, the negative sides of Ketu in these houses would also be felt. But let's talk about how it is considered good in the 4th house. Because 4th house is the Moksha Trikon house. 4, 8 and 12 are the Moksha Trikons. And in the 4th house, the person's wants, the needs are very limited, because see, 4th house is the want of happiness, want of material things which makes you comfortable, and it's your relatives, it's your mother. So these things would not be required by a person, or he may not want those things if it is present in the 4th house. So it is good that you are detached from everything that is giving you happiness, so which means you would be more towards meditation, and thereby leading to salvation. Then comes the 8th house. 8th house is about the higher learnings, the deeper meanings of life, the research part, the occult side. So here Ketu is considered very good, and it again gives you detachment, because once a person is towards knowing the higher sides of life, he will not feel attached with any other thing other than his motive of research. So in the 8th house, Ketu is considered very good. In the 12th house, as I told you, it is the place where the soul will rest after the death happens. The soul will rest here to attain the next birth. So this is the resting place of soul after the death. So Ketu is about salvation, and 12th house is also about salvation. So if Ketu is present here, it means it doesn't require any more births. So it means the person will attain salvation with this placement of Ketu. So this is how Ketu has to be studied. So Ketu is considered very well placed in the fiery signs, that is 1-5-9, and in the watery signs, that is 4-8-12, because here the purpose of Ketu is served very easily. And in the airy signs, the mind would not be stable. And in the earthy sign, that is 2-6-10, here the mind would be again not stable, because the mind would want material things and it would not get, so thereby creating a clash inside the mind. So here in these signs, Ketu is not considered as good. And the exalted sign for Ketu is the Scorpio sign, and the own sign of Ketu is also considered as Scorpio. And Ketu acts like planet Mars, and it gives the results suddenly. And the debilitated sign for Ketu is Taurus, and some believe it is Gemini. So the aspects of Ketu are 5th, 7th, 9th and 12th. As per some texts, 12th aspect is also considered. But if you, in my personal belief, I do not take any aspects of Ketu. I only consider the placement of Ketu wherever it is present. It is going to give the results of the sign, that is the dispositor. And if it is conjunct with any planet, it will give the results of the conjunct planet. So Ketu tends to absorb the energies, or you can say it will lessen the energies of the house where it is present and of the planet with which it is present. So if Ketu is present with, say, planet Venus, in that case Ketu will take away the energies of Venus, and the person would be in want of happiness of the karak tattvas of Venus. So if it is a man's chart, then he will be in want of happiness of his wife. And if it is a female's chart, she will be in want of happiness from her marriage. That's because she owes something to that karak tattva from her past life, and she or he may have some past life connection with their spouse. That is why Ketu is present with Venus. Now, if your Ketu is present with Mars, in that case, Mars is considered as your brother. So it means that you owe something to your brother from your past life. And if your Ketu is with your son, then it means you owe something to your father from your past life, and there would be want of happiness coming through your father. Similarly, if Ketu is with planet Moon, it means you owe something to your mother, and there is some karmic backlog towards your mother from your side. So you will be in want of happiness in relation to your mother, and there would be want of happiness of the things related to Moon. And if Ketu is with Mercury, it means you owe something towards your younger siblings or towards your friends, and in that case you will always be at the complaining side of your life where it is concerning your friends. So that's why Ketu will absorb the energies of the Karka with which it is present. And if it is afflicted also by a malefic planet, it can cause amputation also. So it can be very dangerous, and it should be studied very carefully. And Ketu, if it is in the nakshatra of benefic planets, in that case it will give you good results. And Ketu, if it is in its own nakshatra, you have to see where it is present. That house becomes very strong, and you will be very spiritually inclined in the things related to that house. And Ketu, if it is present in the nakshatra of a malefic planet, suppose Ketu is the nakshatra lord of Mars or of Saturn or of Rahu, then it becomes extremely malefic. you also have to see where the nakshatra lord is sitting. Now the other thing that you should see is that whenever Ketu is present in any given sign, you have to see where the dispositor of that sign is sitting. Suppose Ketu is present in your fifth house. So if the dispositor is placed in the Kendra or in the trine from the fifth house, you have to count 159 or 4, 7, 10. So if Ketu is present, the dispositor of Ketu is present in 4, 7, 10 from its place, or 5, 9 from its place, in that case Ketu will give you very good results under its dasha. But if the dispositor of Ketu is present in 6, 8, 12 from its place, in that case Ketu's results would be not so good, and the person can undergo some kinds of health related major issues. So let me explain this with the help of an example. Suppose Ketu is in the sign of Leo and Sun is present in your 10th house. For you it is in your Kendra, so for you it will do you good. But when it comes to your siblings, when it comes to your children, so from the 5th house comes your children, in that case there would be some sufferings, because from the 5th house, 10th house is your 6th. You count. So from 5th to 9th is your 5th house. Then add 1, that is your 10th house. So which means Ketu, the dispositor of Ketu is present 6 houses away from itself. So for your own growth of life, you will do well. But when it comes to your children, you will have problems, because the dispositor is in the 6th place from itself. So this is how you have to see. If the dispositor is in 6th place to itself, or in 8th or in 12th to its sign, in that case its dasha can be very harmful and it can be very bad for your own health also. So you have to make sure where the dispositor has gone. If it has gone to your 6, 8 or 12, in that case it will be very difficult period for yourself, and this is how it should be seen. So the exalted sign for Ketu is Scorpio, and the own sign for Ketu is also Scorpio, and the debilitated sign for Ketu is Taurus. And some say that the debilitated sign for Ketu is Gemini, but I take only the Taurus sign. And this is how the energies of planet Ketu works. So when Ketu is in the nakshatra of Jupiter, it is considered very good, especially for when there is a connection between Ketu, Jupiter and Saturn. It is a very good combination for astrology. A person can do very well in astrology. So you have to see in what nakshatra is Ketu, and accordingly it will give you results. So with Jupiter, it gives you inclination towards higher learning, and the person can really do well when it comes to the studies of astrology. So it can be also a very good combination for those seeking salvation. So friends, this was all about planet Ketu.